Hi, this is Manangel V. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this traffic surveillance effect in LumaFusion. The effect mimics a traffic monitoring system that scans for cars. The scanning area inside the green square is magnified. Once the system logs onto a car, it displays its license plate number and stays with it for 2 seconds before searching for a new car. The search for the next car takes exactly 1 second. Then the cycle repeats. There are a few tweaks to the effect that make it more realistic. First, there's an overlay title showing the date and the camera number at the top of the screen. Also, the non-zoom traffic camera footage is desaturated and has a slight grainy effect. Meanwhile, the zoomed-in area inside the green square is slightly oversaturated and has a higher contrast. Now, let's dive into LumaFusion and start editing. The project timeline already has 2 copies of the traffic footage. In the track above the first copy, there is a title with guidelines that define the areas where the cars can be chosen for tracking. This ensures that all the cars being scanned travel a similar distance and thus have a similar size. Lastly, there's 1 green square to show the area being scanned. This is a title that has a square shape with a green colored edge and a transparent face color. The green square will be used to show cars that are magnified by 240%. It has been resized to make sure that it fits cars that have been magnified. The duration of all the titles in the project matches the duration of the traffic footage. Edit the second copy of the traffic footage video. This copy of the video will be used to show the magnified scanned area inside the green square. Increase the size to 240. Go back to the timeline. Now let's start tracking the cars. Let's start with this one. Edit the title with a green square. Make sure that you are at the beginning of the title and that frame and fit is selected. Find the car selected. Adjust the position of the green square to fit around the car without changing the size of the square. Add a keyframe. To complete the locking effect on the first car, advance exactly 2 seconds. Move the green square to fit around the car as before. A keyframe will be created automatically. Check that the car fits within the green square throughout the 2 seconds lock. Advance exactly 1 second. Identify the second car that you want to scan. Let's focus on this car on the opposite lane. Move the green square to fit around the second car selected. A keyframe will be created automatically. As before, advance exactly 2 seconds and move the green square to track the movement of the second car. A keyframe will be created automatically. Repeat this process for the remainder of the video. Search for a car for 1 second, track the car for 2 seconds, and then move on to the next one. This is how it looks after this part of the process is done. Now, let's work on the zoomed-in video. Duplicate the title containing the green square and place it above it. The goal is to keyframe the position of the zoomed-in video based on the movements of the green square above it, so that the sequence of cars scanned in the non-zoomed footage align with the zoomed-in version. Edit the zoomed-in video. Make sure that you are at the beginning of the video. Find the first car selected earlier. Adjust the position of the video so the car fits inside the green square. Don't change the size of the video. Add a keyframe. Move forward exactly 2 seconds. This aligns with the end of the time that the first car was tracked earlier in the non-zoomed video. Adjust the position of the video so the car fits inside the green square, again, without changing its size. A keyframe will be created automatically. This is how it looks so far. Advance exactly 1 second. Adjust the position of the video so the second car that you selected earlier now fits inside the green square. A keyframe will be created automatically. Now repeat the process for the second car and then continue with the rest of the cars that were scanned in the non-zoomed video. Be mindful of the timing. Track a car for 2 seconds and then move on to the next one in exactly 1 second. This is how the zoomed-in video looks after this part of the process is done. Now, let's do some cleanup. Delete the title with the green square that is above the zoomed-in footage. Also, delete the title with the guidelines. Next, let's add some additional enhancements to make the effect look more realistic. Desaturate the non-zoomed footage. Slightly increase contrast and saturation of the zoomed-in video. This step will help highlight the difference between the standard traffic footage and the enhanced scanned area. Now add an overlay title showing the date and the camera number at the top of the screen. Add it right above the video that is not zoomed. Next, make the non-zoomed video a bit grainy by adding a TV static overlay. This will emphasize the contrasting quality between the regular traffic footage and the enhanced scanned area. It should look like this. Now let's prepare the non-zoomed video for chroma key. Edit the title with a green square. Set the face color of the green square as magenta. In a few steps, this will allow keying that color out and display the magnified view of the cars in that area. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks now. Now, let's set up the scanning message. This is a label that will appear below the green square, displaying the word searching while the green square moves between cars, and a plate number when it locks onto a car. This is done by duplicating the title with the green square that already contains keyframe movements, and replacing the green square with text. This is how it should look. Now let's put all the pieces together. Export only the non-zoomed video with all the tracks above it. Bring the exported video back into the project. Place it above the zoomed in video. Edit the exported video and use chroma key to key out the magenta color, revealing the full color magnified video in the track below it. Exit back to the timeline, and we are done. This is how the effect looks now. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you're notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.